Good morning. Good morning. So good to be here with you this morning. Welcome.
When he told you you're not good enough, when he told you you're not right, when he told you you're not strong enough to put up a good fight, when he told you you're not worthy, when he told you you're not loved, when he told you you're not beautiful, never be enough. Fear is a liar. He would take your breath, stop you in your steps. Fear is a liar. He will rob your happiness, cast your fear in the fire, cause fear, he is a liar.
Let's cast our fears in the fire this morning. Amen. Yeah.
When he told you you were trouble, forever be alone, when he told you you should run away, never find a home.
That's what he told me.
You were dirty,
he's a liar.
You should be ashamed. When he told you you could be one, the grace can never change.
Let's listen to the whole song. Good word.
Let your fire fall to cast out all our fear.
Let your fire fall to cast out all our fear.
Let your fire fall.
Let it fall.
Love's all our fear.
Love is all we fear this morning, right?
Let your fire fall. Cast out all our fear.
Cast out all our fear this morning, Lord.
Let your fire fall. Love.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you so
much. Let your fire fall.
No fear, guys, no fear. Not here. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. He is a liar. The author of all lies, right? We won't focus on him too much this morning. Let's just acknowledge that fear is a liar, and fear tries to rob from you, tries to take your breath away. But amen, we're looking for the Lord to take our breath away this morning, right? He never ceases to amaze me. There are some days when he gives me confirmation through that number 4444, And I'm so amazed. I'm like, oh my God, he did not just show me that number. You know, he takes my breath away, and he's the one that we want to take our breath away. Amen. Yeah. Yeah, he's the one. Father God, thank you for your Holy Spirit here. Father God, where the Spirit is, there is freedom. And we thank you so much this morning, Lord, for the freedom we have to come before you, to exalt you and worship you and put your name above all names. Your name is great and mighty to be praised. Lord, you are worthy. You are holy. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Amen. Good morning. Who's in the house this morning? Carmine's here, and Chuck and Aaron. My goodness, we're filling up this morning. I see the numbers going up, but it's not about that. Even if there's just one person here with me, amen, we can pray corporately and seek the Lord and ask for his Holy Spirit to come. And he is so faithful, and he's just, he's faithful to come and be with us right when we call on his great and mighty name. So Lord, place on us, place over us the blood of the Lamb shield of protection to guard our heart, soul, body, mind, and our spirits. Let nothing but your love penetrate that blood of the Lamb shield of protection in the name of Jesus Christ. Place on us the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the belt buckle of truth. Shod our feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace of Jesus Christ. Place on our hand the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, by the way, sharper than any double-edged sword. Place on our other hand the shield of faith to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Lead us not into temptation, right? But deliver us, O God, from the wicked one. For yours is the kingdom. Yours is the glory. Yeah. Thank you so much, Lord, for your presence here. Holy Spirit, we love you. And there's nothing more glorious than being in your presence. And there's nothing that I want more than to model a prayer life that is consistently never ceasing from praising and praying to you, O God. There's nothing that I want more than that, and other than you yourself, right? Amen. There's nothing that I want more than to declare your promises over your people, Father God. There's nothing that I want more. There's nothing that we want more, right? We, as we're collectively praying here corporately in this prayer room. And Shirley's here. Good morning, Shirley. Good morning. It's good to see you, my friend, Shirley Chandler of many years. Ellis Ivory is in the house this morning, and George Fevish. Welcome. Welcome back here to our prayer room. And so, Lord, there's nothing that we want more, right, than to be in your presence and declaring your word, your promises over your people, and reading your word, and also praying to you. We know that the effective, fervent prayers of a righteous man availeth much. And I've always said, how much more effective are the prayers of a mother? How many of you mothers or fathers have prayed over your children? You've gone to bat for them in prayer, right? You've really just cried out to God, come and rescue my son, or come and rescue my daughter. And our prayers are effective, and they're heard in the kingdom. And we're just going to pull heaven down this morning. We're going to pull heaven down. We're going to draw, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. That's my favorite. Thy kingdom come, your kingdom come, Lord, your will be done. That is my favorite, to call on the kingdom of God, that we would be kingdom-minded people, right? That sense that we need something more than all the lies we're being told, right? We need you, oh God, and that's why we're here this morning, calling out to you, and we praise you, we exalt you, we worship you, and we can't get enough of you. We can't say that enough, that we praise you, exalt you, and worship you. We can't even, right? You know that saying, oh, I can't even. Well, I can't even. Let's go. We're going to start in Psalms this morning. And Psalm 118 is where the Lord was speaking to me as I prepared last night to bring you some kind of message this morning beside just praying for you. Good morning, Stephen. Amen. You guys, when you like and love the message or when you comment, it gets me all riled up and it encourages me. It's a faith builder. Amen. So thank you so much for commenting and sharing your testimonies with me and with the others through the comments on the post, because it's a faith builder. It gets me more excited for the Lord when you cheer me on, or, you know, cheer him on rather, with the word, with more words. Let's see, we're going into 118, but I don't see what, there it is. I see where it begins. Okay. 118, that's Psalm 118 is where we're starting today. And Psalm 117 is so short that I almost missed 118. Let's just read 117 just for fun. Praise the Lord, all you Gentiles. Laud him, all you peoples. For his merciful kindness is great toward us. And the truth of the Lord endures forever. Praise the Lord. Okay, we're going to read on Psalm 118. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let Israel now say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron now say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord now say, his mercy endures forever. I called on the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and set me in a broad place. The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me? The Lord is for me among those who help me. Therefore, I shall see my desire on those who hate me. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. All nations surrounded me, but in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. They surrounded me. Yes, they surrounded me. But in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. They surrounded me like bees. They were quenched like a fire of thorns. For in the name of the Lord, I will destroy them. You pushed me violently that I might fall. But the Lord helped me. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I love that word, valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord has chastened me severely, but he has not given me over to death. Oh, that's his heart. That's God's heart for us, right? Amen. He chastens us severely, but he has not given us over to death. Amen. Open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them. I will praise the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord, through which the righteous shall enter. Ah, that reminds me, another song. How does that song? Let's see. Open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them. Open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them. And I will praise the Lord. And I will praise the Lord. And I will praise the Lord. For his mercies endure, for his mercy endures. Yeah. Open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them. Yay. Yay. Open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them. Open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them. And I will praise the Lord. And I will praise the Lord. And I will praise the Lord, for his mercy endures. Yeah, thank you, Lord. I will praise you, for you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone, and that's what you are, oh God, the chief cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is where that comes from. If you're familiar with that verse, and I've said it before, yeah, and I've sung that song too. This is a day the Lord has made, and I will rejoice and I will be glad in it. And that is Psalm 118, verse 24. Save now, I pray, O Lord. O Lord, I pray, send now prosperity. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you from the house of the Lord. God is the Lord, and he has given us light. He is light, amen. Look at John, the first chapter today. You'll see the very essence of God is light. And he has given us light. Bind the sacrifice with cords to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, I will exalt you. Guys, this is written in the Old Testament, far before the time of the New Testament, right? And here, there's a reference to God being the light. And you'll read later in the New Testament in John 1 that God is light. And amen, that is the very essence of God. He is light, he is life, and he is love. Yes. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, I will exalt you. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Thank you, Father, for your goodness endures forever. Thank you that we can open the gates. No, we ask you, open to me the gates of righteousness, and I will go through them. That is part of our prayer this morning, is open to us the gates of righteousness, Lord, and we will walk through them. Amen. Are you with me? Psalm 119, I love 41 through 48. Let's read on in the next psalm. We're going to go to verse 41. Verse 41. So we're in Psalm 119, verse 41. Let your mercies come also to me, O Lord, your salvation according to your word. So shall I have an answer for him who reproaches me, for I trust in your word. And take not the word of truth utterly out of my mouth, for I have hoped in your ordinances. So shall I keep your law continually, forever and ever. And I will walk at liberty, for I seek your precepts. I will speak of your testimonies also before kings, and I will not be ashamed. And I will delight myself in your commandments, which I love. My hands also I will lift up to your commandments, which I love. And I will meditate on your statutes. Yes, Lord. Yeah. My hands also I will lift up to your commandments, which I love. And I will meditate on your statutes. Verse 45 said, and I will walk at liberty, for I seek your precepts. I will speak of your testimonies also before kings. They cannot shut me up. Amen. They cannot shut me up. The devil is a liar and he cannot shut me up. And as a little girl, I believed many of the lies I was told that I heard in my head. And I had a transformation take place in my body, in my heart, in my soul. In 1992, when I was saved, the Redeemer came and literally reached his hand right in, grabbed my heart, and captivated me through a group of people who were praising him and exalting him and putting him first. And when I saw the demonstration of the love that these people had for God and how he responded to them, amen, it captivated my heart, and the Lord set me free. He set me free. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. There truly is. And in that place, in that room, in that sanctuary where they were praising God and they were literally getting on their hands and face, they wanted more of God. They kept asking, and you know, I saw that demonstration of God's people loving on him. And I saw that demonstration of God's true love, and I could not resist. And this girl was redeemed. This girl was transformed. I was set free, and the Lord has been so forever faithful to me. And so I am here as a God-fearing, and I do fear him, American citizen who loves America. I love America, and I love our leadership. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you are so faithful. And good morning, everyone. Welcome. It's great to have you here this morning. We're talking about, and we are exercising our freedom. Amen. While we can exercise our freedom on this public platform. And I'm so sorry, George Benner is in the house. Yay, I'm happy for that. But I'm so sorry, he says he has no sound. I don't know how to help you with that. And I can see that we do have, others do have sound this morning. So I hope that you are able to figure that out. You might want to exit out of this. I'm sure you can't hear me, but I know that if you exit out and return, come back in, you'll fix that problem, I'm sure. 2 Corinthians in the New Testament is where we're going next. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. We're going to start in verse 12. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. David Copley. Oh my Lord, David. We had a good song this morning. Welcome. It's good to see you, my friend. It's been a while. Welcome. It's good to see you. So very nice to have David Copley. David Copley was one of my, both Justin and Alex had David Copley for a teacher at Ocean View School. And I'm guessing you're retired by now. If not, the COVID probably forced you into it. Anyways, good morning. Good to have you guys here this morning. We're going to start in 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 12. Therefore, since we have such hope, we use great boldness of speech, and amen, yes, I do. Yeah, there's no grandstanding here. I heard someone mention that he had hoped there would be no grandstanding where there's prayer. Well, hey, I'm going to stand right up there. I'm going to be a grandstand. Amen. I'm going to be a grandstand, and I'm going to boldly speak the truth about God and about Jesus and about the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. And I am going to, oh, David Copley says he retired in June. Well, congratulations. I know that's quite a change for you. And oh my goodness, you've been teaching all these years. And didn't you have a world map in your room? I have a world map behind me. I was thinking of the classroom where Shannon and I, hey, you guys, I've talked about in a previous message how my friend Shannon and I started the frog team years ago, and there was a teacher that let us meet in his classroom. Well, guess what? David Copley is here this morning. Praise the Lord. Thanks, David, for your willingness to let us have the frog team and meet in your classroom at the school and talk about God and Jesus. And so I gave a message not too long ago when I found a t-shirt in a thrift store that said total chaos and it had all these little toads all over it jumping around. And I said, praise the Lord. Yeah, we're not going to focus on total chaos that we can see in as the nations are raging around us, but we're going to focus on frog, fully rely on God, right? That was a great message. And thank you so much for being here this morning, David. So let's continue to read on in 2 Corinthians, sorry to mislead you, chapter 3, in verse 12. Therefore, since we have such hope, we use great boldness of speech, unlike Moses, who put a veil over his face so that the children of Israel could not look steadily at the end of what was passing away. But their minds were blinded, for until this day the same veil remains unlifted in the reading of the Old Testament, because the veil is taken away in Christ. But even to this day, when Moses is read, a veil lies on their heart. Nevertheless, when one turns to the Lord, the veil is taken away. Thank you, Lord. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And you know what freedom is. You know what liberty is because you live in America. And we're going to fight with our God-given rights to keep liberty and justice at the foundations of this country. Amen. Yes, we are. We're going to speak with great boldness. But we all, with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, are being transformed, amen, into the same image from glory to glory, just as by the Spirit of the Lord. Lord, you are so faithful. You are so faithful to meet us right where we're at. We love you and we thank you so much for your presence this morning. You are like a present to us, oh God, right? You are like a present, a gift to us. You actually do give us the free gift of salvation. And Matthew, Mark, Luke. We're going to Luke chapter 4. I mentioned yesterday that we were going to talk about... and I'm going to tell you in just 1 minute. Yeah, Lord is good. Yeah, Satan tempts Jesus, right? Then Jesus, being filled with the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being tempted for 40 days by the devil. And in those days, he ate nothing. And afterward, when they had ended, he was hungry. And the devil said to him, if you are the Son of God, command this stone to become bread. But Jesus answered him, saying, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. Then the devil, taking him up on a high mountain, showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. In a moment of time, the devil showed the Lord all the kingdoms of the world. Is that interesting? And the devil said to him, all this authority I will give you and their glory, for this has been delivered to me, and I give it to whomever I wish. Therefore, if you will worship me, all will be yours. And Jesus answered and said to him, get behind me, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only you shall serve. Well, that's what we say this morning to you. Satan, you are under our feet as we glorify God and we read his word. And we come into agreement that, yes, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only you shall serve. We come in agreement with Jesus's red letters in Luke chapter 4. Then he brought him to Jerusalem, set him on the pinnacle of the temple, and said to him, if you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you. Guess where we've read that before, right? Psalm 91, when we declare God's promise over his people that he will give his angels charge over you to keep you. And here it is again in the New Testament, in the gospel of Jesus Christ. And in their hands they shall bear you up, The angels shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Hey, the kids and I had an experience. One time we were driving to Ocean View School, where David Copley worked as a teacher for years, labored as a teacher. And we were driving there, and a car backed out of a driveway on the very street that I live on now. And anyways, a car backed out, and our car was literally lifted up into the left lane. And I know this because my son Alex and I were both witnesses to it. And it was amazing. It was like the angels were given charge over us, and they bared us up, you know, lest we dash our foot. You know, we could have had a really bad accident. That car would have sideswiped us. And by the way, there was an assignment of death broken off by a prophet that came to speak in San Luis Obispo not too long after that, because we had actually had, I don't know if you're aware of this, David, but we had three accidents on Elm Street, down the street from the school, between Jack in the Box and the car wash. We were rear-ended twice and sideswiped once at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. It was literally the exact same time of the day, three times, and at 3 p.m., we were hit in our car. And I'm telling you, there later I found out there was an assignment of death on our lives, and it was broken off. Jesus' name, amen. And right across the way there, that's where the angels lifted the car up and lifted us up out of the way. No way could I have moved quickly enough. Anyways, let's read on in Luke chapter 4, verse 12. And Jesus answered and said to him, "It has been said, you shall not tempt the Lord your God." Now when the devil had ended every temptation, he departed from him until the opportune time. Then Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit to Galilee, and news of him went out through all the surrounding region. And he taught in their synagogues, being glorified by all. So he came to the Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up to read. And he was handed the book of the prophet Isaiah, and when he opened the book, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor." Amen. "He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and recover the sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord," to proclaim liberty to the captives. Ah. Then he closed the book and gave it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all who were in the synagogue were fixed on him. And he began to say to them, "Today this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." Amen. Just by your hearing this scripture, it is fulfilled. So all bore witness to him and marveled at the glorious words which proceeded out of his mouth. And they said, "Is this not Joseph's son?" You will surely say this proverb to me, "Physician, heal yourself. Whatever we have done in Capernaum, do also here in your country." Then he said, "Assuredly, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own country. But I tell you truly, many widows were in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the heaven was shut up 3 years and 6 months, and there was a great famine throughout all the land. But to none of them was Elijah sent except Zarephath in the region of Sidon, to a woman who was a widow. And many lepers were in Israel in the time of Elisha the prophet, and none of them was cleansed except Naaman the Syrian." So all those in the synagogue, when they heard these things, were filled with wrath, and rose up and thrust him out of the city. And they led him to the brow of the hill on which their city was built, that they might throw him down over a cliff. Then passing through the midst of them, he went his way. He was cast out. Jesus was cast out. Then he went down to Capernaum, a city of Galilee, and was teaching them on the Sabbaths. And they were astonished at his teaching, for his word was with authority. Now in the synagogue where the there was a man who had a spirit of unclean demon, and he cried out with a loud voice, saying, Let us alone. What have we to do with you, Jesus of Nazareth? Did you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God. But Jesus rebuked him, that spirit in that man, saying, Be quiet and come out of him. And when the demon had thrown him in their midst, it came out of him and did not hurt him. Then they were all amazed and spoke among themselves, saying, What a word is this? For with authority and power he commands the unclean spirits, and they come out. And the report about him went out into every place in the surrounding region. Now he arose from the synagogue and entered Simon's house. But Simon's wife's mother was sick with a high fever, and they made a request of him concerning her. So he stood over her and rebuked the fever. We have that authority, amen, to rebuke the spirit of infirmity and loose from heaven the spirit of health and prosperity. Thank you, Jesus. And it left her. So again, he stood over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. And immediately she arose and served them. When the sun was setting, all those who had any that were sick with the various diseases brought them to him. And he laid his hands on every one of them and healed them. And demons also came out of many, crying out and saying, You are the Christ, the Son of God. And he, rebuking them, did not allow them to speak, for they knew that he was the Christ. Now when it was day, he departed and went into a deserted place. And the crowd sought him and came to him and tried to keep him from leaving them. But he said to them, I must preach the kingdom of God to the other cities also, because for this purpose I have been sent. And he was preaching in the synagogues of Galilee. And that is Luke 4:44. And he was preaching in the synagogues of Galilee. Father God, we thank you for this word is true. We thank you, Father God, that your word is true, that it is the way, the truth, and the life. We thank you, Lord, that heaven has come down this morning. Glory has fallen. The fire has fallen. Thank you, Lord, for meeting us here in this place. Thank you, Lord, for giving us your word, for where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And thank you, Lord, that you have set the captives free. Thank you, Lord, that you did come to heal. You are Jehovah Rapha, our healer. Yes, God. Jehovah Rapha, our healer. And you can see there where he gave testimony of healing unclean spirits coming out of people, and he cleansed them of all unrighteousness in an instant. He rebuked unclean spirits and they left. James 4:7 says, resist the devil and he will flee. He has to. When we believe God is the Father and he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life, right? Eternal life. When we believe in him and we believe that he left a deposit of the Holy Spirit, we have that authority. We have that same authority by the power of his Holy Spirit to cast out demons, to bring healing through Jesus Christ. And we thank you so much for that, Lord, that we have access to that kind of power. Yes, Satan is rising up, is acting out. There's a demonic presence over the nations, and the nations are raging. But guess what? Greater is he. 1 John 4:4, you can look it up for yourself. 1 John 4:4, greater is he who is in me, who is in us, than he who is in this world. The power of God is way, way more powerful than Satan and his little imps. So he is under our feet this morning. We declare liberty, because where there is the Spirit of the Lord, there is liberty. Amen. And that is the title today of your message, of our message. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There is freedom. And this country was built on the justice and righteousness of his foundations. It's built on Christian Judeo foundation, and we are going to give it our all, right? But we are not alone. We are not in this spiritual battle by ourselves. Oh no. And yes, this is a spiritual battle. God is the good guy and Satan is the bad guy. But guess what? He sent his only begotten Son that whoever believes in him will not perish but have everlasting life. Eternal life looks like an infinite line from the east to the west, and your life is but a scratch on it, although very significant. And while you're here, will you please enter in with me to his presence and call on his great name and say and agree with me, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Yes, there is freedom in the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this great country. Thank you for your great name. Thank you, Lord. And we are going to stand with you, Father God, and we will be bold. We will not be shut up. This is the year of the mouth, and we will be bold. In your name, we will come and we will cast out the evil one. He will be under our feet. Amen. 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 Greater is he who is in us than he who is in this world. That's right. The word says, greater is he who is in you than he is in this world. Greater is he who is in me than he who is in this world. We will not be shut up. Our boldness is coming. The remnant, the ecclesia is rising up. The church, we are all the church. We make up the church. We are the body. And we are rising up. We have risen. And we are taking a bold stand with Jesus Christ at our side, as he's at the side of God, right? He is in God's bosom. He is at the right hand of God. And he has given us the power of the Holy Spirit to come boldly and overcome the enemy. That's right. We have overcome. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. So take that, Satan. Is that all you got? Is that all you have, Satan? We already overcame you. God loves you. I love you. I feel the Holy Spirit here. Continue on with him. Bless your day in Jesus' name. And it's Happy Friday. Have a great weekend. I will see you again on Monday.